What's up guys, Sad here. So there was plenty of excitement when AMD last year announced a partnership with Samsung that would bring RDNA graphics to smartphones. But we haven't heard much since then, until last week when a GPU benchmark leak of this new AMD GPU was leaked, where the graphics benchmark alone absolutely pummeled the relatively stout Adreno 650 GPU found in Qualcomm Snapdragon 865 SoC by displaying numbers that are almost 3 times more than Qualcomm's latest offerings. The Exynos 1000, which is a 5nm processor powering the next year's Samsung flagship, will have this new AMD graphics. But it looks like Samsung and AMD aren't focused on just smartphones, but they want to conquer the gaming console market as well. Yes, Nintendo is tipped to be among the first third-party partners to adopt this SoC from Samsung and AMD, which should give it a significant boost, not only processing performance compared to the Switch current console family, but also a vastly superior graphics subsystem. The current Nintendo Switch is powered by a refreshed version of the Nvidia Tegra X1 SoC, a hardware that was first debuted back in 2015, and ever since it hasn't received any improvement in the chip department. However, Nintendo is seriously considering leaving Nvidia behind in favor of Samsung and AMD for better performance. By the way, Sony has already selected AMD's RDNA architecture for the next PlayStation, so it kinda gives me chills thinking that the 2021 Samsung flagships will have the same graphics architecture used by the biggest players in the gaming console market. Regardless, it's about time Samsung ditched the Mali GPU, which was one of the biggest reasons for the inferior performance from the Exynos chips. The Samsung AMD team should bring some real competition to Apple and Qualcomm next year, and the Galaxy S21 could be the first phone in a long while to do just that. Of course, Qualcomm is not gonna sit still. Their next chipset will bring major improvements as well, the specifications of which have been leaked as well. But apart from the names of the chip components, we don't have any numbers to gauge the performance gains from Qualcomm's flagship chipset next year. I guess time will tell who's gonna reign supreme when the battle for the supremacy is gonna take place next year with the Galaxy S21. So we have sales numbers for smartphones sold in quarter one of this year. And not surprisingly, the iPhone 11 tops the chart with sell-in shipments estimated at 18 million units. Redmi Note 8 took the number 2 spot, while Samsung's Galaxy A51 was the third most popular and the best-selling smartphone for Samsung for that period. Samsung sold 6 million units of these phones in Q1. Apart from the Galaxy A51, 3 other Galaxy A phone series were among the 10 best-selling phones globally: Galaxy A10s, A20s, and A01. Unlike Apple, however, not a single Samsung flagship phone made it to the top 10 list, which should give them a lesson to price their flagship sensibly next time. Anyway, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.